the stream going. Hello, everyone. That's better. Okay. It was picking up my mouse and other sound effects. Out to all the platforms that I want it to. All right, it is going out on Facebook. That's good. All right, and we are going out on LinkedIn. Perfect. Let me double check to see if the audio is working. Give me just a second. Testing, testing. Excellent. That is working as well. That makes me happy. All right, so since those are going out, I am also assuming that it is going out on Twitch as well. So we'll get started in a minute or two. Just wanted to let everybody know, my name is Charles Fernandez. I'm a 3D modeler. I have been using Maya for, 20 years now, at least. That's, actually no, 22 years now. Today I'll be modeling, beginning to model a retro pack for something that I'm going to put together for the Unreal Marketplace. I want to create some things that I had from my childhood growing up in the late 70s, early 80s, starting with this old Zenith TV. It was a Zenith color, super color chrome. 1973 with a futuristic looking Aventi body. So yeah, I'll be working on this today. I did kind of get a head start on it a couple days ago, but I might want to go back and I'm gonna end up fixing a couple things as we go along. But we'll see how it goes, how it does. If anybody has any questions, or if anybody is watching at all, feel free to ask, and hopefully I will see it in the chat that I have set up. I'll be able to see what's going on. And here we go. I might not talk much during the stream. I'll probably just jam out to the music. Unless someone has a question, if they have a question, I'll answer it. Other than that, I will just be using this as a work session, like a jam session. So, and away we go. So this camera, if I'm not mistaken, yes, I have it locked so that I can't move it. That's good. But yes, I had this guide. Yep. So this was a pain in the butt to do, lining up this particular angle. I'll show you. Matching the camera angle to a reference photo that I had of this object, because it was very difficult to find. I couldn't find a side view of this TV, and I wanted to get this angle right. And I couldn't until I had lined up this shot. It's not perfect, but it'll do for this instance. This isn't going to be an exact one-to-one replica. It's just gonna be like my memory of it. Okay, so, let's see, some decisions to be made. How do I want to approach this? All right. Start with an extrusion. So this will be the outer shell. I'm just working on the white exterior portion of it. And I can worry about the interior later. So what I'll do now, I'll just make a duplicate, move that up so that I can focus on this. Out. I can add some more details to this. I can give that a really nice curve without adding geometry to the interior of the TV. Being reflected on the back side. So that's fine. Didn't miss a piece of geometry here. And I'll fill that in later. Making sure that I have things lined up with the photo reference. Get this nice and centered. Alright, now add a little more detail to this arch and this arch. Might want to just work on one side of it and then mirror the geometry. Hmm. The music is supplied by Artlist. I just got a subscription for it so that I can work with music, so that I can avoid getting copyright strikes, because that is definitely something that has hounded me in my previous attempts to do streams. I can't just work in silence. It's not something that is conducive to my productivity. So this is fun. All right, so now we've got this. I can extrude this edge to the back. There it is. Oh, I made a mistake. That happens on occasion. Try that again. There we are. Yeah, I think that'll be fine. Now, a little bit of add polygon. You know, I don't know if it would be more effective to do add polygon or just fill a hole and then cut it up. By the way, it doesn't really take that long to do this, so. I suppose it would probably take the same amount of time whether I am adding polygon or filling hole and then slicing it all. I'm going to need to do the same thing. Oh, that's not good. What's that? Hold on. That looks like a mosaic. Let's try that again, because that didn't look right. There we go. Yeah. Didn't know what that was all about, but. So we've got the outer shell complete. Actually, no, I take that back. Some attention does need to be paid to the base. And that's what I was gonna do. So there is, these corners are round, like these are rounded corners. So I need to round out this area on the front and the back. And also this is a slope here. So I'm gonna taper this as well. Let's see, what is the best way to tackle that? I will do it this way. We'll see if this works. Nope, that was not the best decision. Let's see. Not the best. No, that could work. That could work. I'm adding a lot of... You know what? Yeah, I am adding a lot of unnecessary geometry, so I will not do that. I might separate out the base. Or... Let's see. Yeah. I might add this back in. All right, so do another one of these. Duplicate. I get the feeling that this should all be one solid piece, so I might go back in and unify them, but right now I'm just looking to get the shape that I want. Kind of ballparking this right now, and that's not really my style recently. I don't eyeball things anymore. At least I shouldn't eyeball things anymore. Let's do this. Like, I want it to be symmetrical. So, let's do this. Oh. No wonder I'm not seeing it in the guide. It's too low. All right. Bring it back up. The multi-cut tool. This reminds me of the slice tool from way back in the day, but doesn't quite exist anymore. But yeah, this works just as well. Actually does remind me a lot of the original slice tool. And that works. Channeling my inner Bob Ross, you know. There we go. Sometimes we need to take a step back and relax and just relish the simple pleasure of making something. Corners. Need that top-down view now. I hardly use it, but in this case, might have to make that a little tighter. Also have to add a few more vertices because that's not quite getting it done either. Oh, what am I thinking? I also want to grab these. That way I can round these edges too. I feel like these need to come a little further out. Every shift of my weight on this chair is really having an impact here. So, all right, and now that we've got that, add another one of these. Flare going. There we go. Actually, I feel like that needs to be a little more subtle. There we go. So let's smooth out these edges because we can. Soften the edge. And then this edge, harden that back up. Yeah. All right. Maybe a little. Because that's really soft. So I can scale it now. Let's do that. Maybe not. Something about that doesn't seem right. Too sharp. I'm probably adding too many of these dividers now. Yeah, no, I don't like that. Or at least... Alright, oh, what I can do is this. I'll take this section and collapse it. There. Nope. Wait a second. What is that? Okay, yeah, no, that's fine, I think. Yeah. Oh, that's not good. Let's fix that real quick. Soften the edges, but I thought I had only softened these interior lines, but I guess not. There we go. Hmm. Yeah, that's better. So now, all right. So this TV, like I said, has a tilt to it on the front face, but I'm not going to deal with that just yet. I'm going to work on, you know what, let's see about reuniting these two pieces. Yeah, that should be easy. Let's do this. Alright. First order of business is we no longer need these edges. Honestly, it probably was a better idea just to keep them separate. Would have saved. You know what? I will do that. In the interest of keeping this as low poly as possible, there's no reason to have these be a solid piece. Like you're not. I mean, unless I'm staring at the underside of it, which you know could happen. But let's do this. Selected, you unite all those to the center, and then just delete these because that is now one single square. All right, so the outer shell is complete, and we are currently only at 130 polygons. Forgot that I had extruded that. I didn't need to extrude that. this. This is the alignment that I need. Wait, what the? What is this? Oh, that's right. There's some funkiness happening here. That is weird. Okay, so what we will do is we will discard this. We don't need it. Let's go right back to using a cube. All right. We don't have to mess with the dimensions here, but we're gonna. Just because it helps me in a way, I think, to have a sense of what the scale is. Right now we're operating in feet. That's the standard unit that I've chosen for preferences. Screw it. We don't have to do that. All right, yeah. Also, this is not going to be the actual depth of it, because that top is tapered. But for the sake of creating this, it'll do for now. So that's the top of the TV, and we'll move that away for now because we're not going to use it immediately. Drop this down. All right. Yeah. This isn't aligned perfectly. Now that I'm looking at it. But the camera that took this picture had some imperfections to it. Or at least it had like the lens angle, you know, distorted the image a little bit. The angle was probably a little bit off. Thank you. also what we can do is we will split this up a bit on the corners, these corners. Bit of a curve here. See, this is going to be inset, so it doesn't have to line up perfectly, and it doesn't have to be perfectly symmetrical. We're going to give this a bit of a curve so that the corners aren't sticking out. Oh, I no longer hear music. Let me see if that shuffle is still going. I don't think it is. All right, let's try that again. From the top. Thought I had enough music to last, at least... at least for an hour, but apparently I did not. Well, I could. Let's do that. I will attempt to stream directly from the website. Hopefully that doesn't kill my broadcast too much. Listen to some blues, I think. Genre. Yeah. Just start from the top, work our way down. That was a bit excessive. There we go. Super loud. Divide this is what I need to do. Also need to extrude this. Alright, so this is how we're going to deal with that. Let's see how we solve this particular issue. So does this. these are interesting little geometric problems that I want to try. It's like I want to try and find the most elegant solution for it, but sometimes there really isn't one. But nothing wrong with playing around with different options to see what works, what doesn't work. I haven't quite made up my mind about this particular... You know what? Yeah, we'll go back to... this particular solution. Looks like I picked up a couple of viewers. I'm going to say hello. Hope everybody's doing well. See what we can do about creating this bevel. That'll be a bit of a trick. So I'm gonna add some more complexity as I go down. You know what? One thing I could do is separate it out again. I might end up doing that. There is no rule saying that it has to all be one complete peak, one solid piece. It doesn't. Keep forgetting that. It's like force of habit to try and make it all one solid mesh. Like that's just an old habit, and sometimes it needs to die. Old habits need to die sometimes. Be able to make the right selection one of these days. That's the screen. Oh. You know what? Okay. Got that. That's good. Again, select the corners, try love, a little bit of rounding. Now I'm basically just lining things up with the photograph. Here's the beautiful part about this. I don't have to stick with this. And I'll explain more about what I mean as I go along. Little bit of a curve here. Maybe pull this down just a hair. Alright, so right now we're just trying to mash up this outer curve a little bit. This. Give it a little. So now we got this, but we don't have to stick with it. We can delete this out.
Step down this lonesome road.
bit more definition here. Maybe that was not. Oh, wait a second. Some bitch. Yep, that'll do it, I think. Let's see. Now that we have this, we can extrude again. There we go. The trick about this is I know that eventually I'm going to have to change all this again anyway. Because the CRT monitor is going to sit in here, and there's going to be a slight curve to the monitor this way and this way. So I'm going to have to sort of bulge this area out so that it will fit. And then the whole thing is at a slight angle. Keep forgetting again that the photo isn't lined up perfectly, so not all the corners, not all the edges are going to line up perfectly. I need to be okay with that. All right. Yeah, that is looking pretty good.
Goodness. 100 pills per person, big pharma getting paid. 100 pills per person.
I am digging this. The model and the blues. So, I'm going to look up something here real quick, see if I can find, All right. Okay, so I found something that I think might be helpful. So right now I am downloading a rough schematic for a cathode ray tube so that I have a decent idea of the curvature for the TV screen. So, give me just a moment. And I'm going to load it onto a view plane here. Scale it up. Do the same thing for the top view. Alright, and it would sort of sit in that lip there. So, those are the rough approximate dimensions for the tube. I'm going to make that now. And let's see. What we can do is we can take the geometry that we've created so far and hide it on a new layer. Focus just on the tube. Now, I don't have to make this entire structure. In fact, I'm definitely not going to do that on account of it wouldn't even be accurate. So, because like I don't know how deep it was in real life. I know it was huge and it took up probably the entire depth of the TV. So, this is not 100% accurate, but it's close enough for now, at least. What we're gonna do now this, say, 5 subdivisions on the width and the height. All right. We'll see. I'll say, actually, let's do 6 and 6. I want to shout out to the ones that they know. My sweet baby looks so. She got me going, yeah, she turns me on. She loves me. Yeah, she loves me. And it blows my mind. Start moving it out. Yep. I did want to add more. Alright. Too much further. Let me add this and this. Thank you. All right, so let's see. Beautiful. So now that has a nice little arc to it. That screen is pretty good. So now we adjust this interior to match the arc. Right. This is coming out pretty fun. Soften the edge on all of this, and then go back in and harden the edges where needed.
Next time I hold, gonna have my woman by my side.
There we go. Maybe that's what I need to do. Oh, you know what? Let's try that. This is pinching a little bit too much to my taste, so I will attempt to spread this out a little bit. Yeah, this distortion is kind of bugging me. Not a fan. Even out that curve a little bit. This too. It's fine. On this side, it needs to move. All right. Still kind of bugs me, but that is a lot better than it was. What the hell it is? I'm
sometimes you have to look at it from every conceivable angle. Oh, duh. What am I thinking? This is such a... it's not a sharp edge, but it's sharp enough that it needs a little more definition. That's the issue, I think. Yeah. Yeah, that's better. Just needed a holding edge.
Go through the entire playlist? I think I did. Hot damn. Alright. It is almost about time for me to wrap this stream up. I was only planning on going through till 5 o'clock. Got about 10 minutes left. So I'm going to piddle around a little bit. Let's see what else I can do. Yeah, I like that a lot better. That curve, that distortion has been largely eliminated, and that works for me. Oh, let me smooth these out, because I added these curves. They might not actually have an edge. No, they're pretty smooth. That works. Beautiful. All right, so I have most of this done now. I'm going to add the dials, possibly at a later time. I know I need to seal up the back end, but that's not really an issue at the moment. Next steps will be completing the base geometry, UV mapping, and once it's UV mapped, taking it into Substance Painter and recreating some of these surface textures. So that'll be fun. But in the meantime, let's check out another playlist. I can't believe I listened to everything on the blues channel. That's not a lot of music. Let's see. Oh, you know, I had an duration. Let's go with cinematic. I think I heard this already. Yeah, this is just, it's cross-listed. It's basically, I think this was already in the blues channel, but it's also got a cinematic quality to it, so it's on this list already. All right, let's see. I know I have reference image, a close-up of these knobs that I'll be taking a look at now. That is not at all. Okay. Thank you. version of this. Let's see, save as version 2. And also, because it's good practice, delete all my type history. And I could freeze transformations on it now too. That way, if I move something out of the way, all I have to do is zero it out and it comes right back to where it was. So this is not the control knobs, but it is a close up of another Zenith, and they all had the same knobs. Oh wow. All right, so yeah, I'll take a look at this. See about making it. This shouldn't be too difficult. Oh yeah, this was the chroma color too. This is what I have is the super chroma color. But what I had was the super chroma color. Be eyeballing this based on the reference images. Don't need is the back of this. Don't need the back faces. Oh, you know what? I want more definition in this. Yeah, no. 20 should be fine, actually. Yeah, I don't need to go overboard. Thank you.
Looks like there's a little bit of a bow to this. looks cool. Fairly simple, but look at that. Man, come here. Yeah, gets the point across. So I'll be smoothing out the edges here and pretty much calling it a day because it is now 5 o'clock. I wasn't planning on streaming any longer than this. So let me smooth this out. Smooth. Yep. Yeah. Just these. Oh, yeah, no. I'll need to spend a little more time, a little more attention on the details here, but overall, I'm fairly happy with how it's come out. Thank you. Yeah, that's pretty cool. That'll be it for now. I'm comfortable wrapping it up for the moment. Yeah, that's fun. And like I said, it does have a tilt to it that I will be incorporating. So yeah, there's definitely an angle to the set that I'll be implementing next time, I think. So in the meantime, thank you for watching. This has been Charles Fernandez. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching. Watching me jam. So have a nice night, guys. And as always.